Hi, my name is Arielle Di Stefano, and I'm a Board Certified Behavior Analyst with Brett DiNovi Associates. Today we're going to talk about Delayed Denial Tolerance Training. Delayed Denial Tolerance Training is a behavior analytic strategy designed by Dr. Gregory Hanley with the purpose of shaping tolerance to delayed reinforcement and denials. This teaching strategy is embedded in the larger framework of SBT, or skill-based teaching. In applied behavior analysis, a common approach to addressing challenging behavior involves teaching and reinforcing a functionally alternative behavior. For instance, if a student is motivated by an iPad and typically screams to gain access, a practitioner might shape the demand, "Can I have the iPad, please?" and reinforce this request by granting access to the iPad. Once a student is independent in making requests for preferred items, ABA practitioners will teach and reinforce a tolerance response. Tolerance responses are emitted following a practitioner notifying the student that their request isn't available right now or at all. Practitioners will shape an appropriate tolerance response based on the student's communication style, such as a high five or saying okay. Practitioners will provide access to the original request following a student successfully implementing the tolerance response with statements such as, "Thanks for letting me know you're okay. Never mind, you can have the iPad now." The practitioner will now utilize a variable schedule of reinforcement to reinforce 1, either the original request, 2, the trained tolerance response, 3, waiting for a variable amount of time, or 4, deny the request altogether. Alternating responses to requests for preferred items and activities mimics the natural environment. Sometimes reinforcement isn't available right now, and sometimes it's not available at all. The tolerance to delays and denials are strengthened by keeping the consequences unpredictable, much like our experiences in our day-to-day lives. In Idelstein and Colleagues 2021, therapists trained parents to implement delay and denial tolerance training via telehealth with 4 participants. The mean reduction in challenging behavior across 4 participants relative to baseline was 93% in both delay and denial training trials. Parents began with delay trials of 5 seconds, gradually increasing to a terminal delay of up to 3 minutes, following 3 consecutive sessions without challenging behavior. Denial trials involved offering a lower preferred activity following a denial statement, such as, "It's not available right now, but you can play with this instead." Both delay and denial trials required appropriate waiting behavior, which was defined as the absence of target maladaptive behavior prior to reinforcement access in delay trials, or verbal praise for denial trials. The final phase of treatment involved interspersing denial trials with wait trials in order to further generalize the skill of tolerance to delayed reinforcement within the natural environment. This study extends on Hanley's original delay and denial treatment programs by utilizing telehealth to coach parents to exert stimulus control with their children, as well as reinforcing the absence of challenging behavior in order to gain access to delayed reinforcement. Thanks so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe to our channel. Any questions about the content of this video can be left in the comment section below.